Hello and welcome. In this session, we are going to look at how to present relevant information to our website users using what is called exposed filters. This is our default installation of Drupal. If you have been following this series in the last 40 odd videos, the site is slightly looks different because I cleaned up a few things. Okay, the default Drupal installation already uses exposed filters that you can see. It's in the content area, viewing content. This is what is called exposed filter, this part here. So you can say, for example, you only want to see basic page, you filter it, you only see basic page. If you want to see only training course, you filter it, and you only see training course. So this is what is called an exposed filter. What the exposed filter will do is it helps the users to navigate to certain information very quickly. To see this filter, we can see that under structure, views, this is the content. This is the default content page view. Edit. We are not editing, we are just having a look. So this is the view, and these are the filter criteria. As you can see, some of the filters are what's called exposed filters, and some of them grouped. So let us create an exposed filter for our site. Go back to this site. I went ahead and created an article view. This is the article view. If you have been following along in the last 40 videos or so, we created many views. So you know how to create views. So this is an article view. Some time ago we installed a module, devel module, and using the devel module we created a lot of dummy articles. Okay, and these audience type what we called for it is the controlled vocabulary. Okay, so this is the article view I created, and this is the exposed filter I added. So let's see how to do this. Let us look at the configuration of it. Go to views, edit view. So this is the view for the article content types, and see that I added a filter criteria called content audience type. It is exposed, so that's what it is. What I will do is I can just delete this one and we can recreate it. So go under rearrange. So I'm going to delete that exposed filter, remove and apply and save. So that exposed filter is now removed. So this is the articles view. So let us go ahead and add that exposed filter here, so you know what to do. So go to edit view, and we are going to add a filter. In the filter criteria, we are going to add another filter. Add. What are we going to add? We are going to add audience type. That's right. There we go. That's the one we are going to add. So apply. And the vocabulary is the our target audience, that is the control vocabulary we created. And selection type is, it is not autocomplete. If it is autocomplete, people need to know what they are looking for. So let us say drop down. And do you want to see hierarchy? Yes. Apply and continue. And expose this filter to visitors? Yes. And let me see. That's all there is. Multiple selection? Yes. Sometime you can. The article may be office workers and university, whatever, there may be multiple. You can leave the rest as it is. Apply this display. You can have a preview here. There we are. Oh, we don't want, this is the machine name. We don't want that. So let us go change that. This is, I think, some sort of a bug in Drupal 8. Delete it. Drupal 8 is still evolving. I hope by the end of 2016, things will be much better. Apply this display and save. Saving changes. So there we are. So we now added an exposed filter to our article content type view. This is the article view. This is an exposed filter. Let's see if it is working or not. Say we want articles meant only for office workers. Click on that. Apply. So what we see? There's office worker like that. And if we choose Cambridge University, apply. There we are. Cambridge University, Cambridge University, Cambridge University, like that. So that is how you add an expose filter to your views. Expose filter is a great tool for delivering useful content to our site visitors. Great, now you know how the expose filter works in Drupal. Make use of it and make your site more user-friendly. Very good. Thank you for watching.